My name is Ifat Afek. I'm a system architect at Nokia Cloud Bank, and I've been working with Nokia for 5 years, and in the last 2 years, I'm the PTL of Vitrage product. I think I started on the very first days of the project. We were a very big team, and we just had like nice ideas and diagrams, and 6 months later, we were already an official OpenStack project, which is very fast. And now, after 2 years, the product is running in production. I know that at least at Nokia products, we have like cloud and infrastructure software, which is the NFB infrastructure solution based on OpenStack, and we have CloudBand Network Director, which is the NFB orchestrator of Nokia, and both of them are using Vitrage. So personally, I'm really proud of the journey we've made, and I'd be very happy to see other people join us. So Vitrage is the OpenStack root cause analysis service. It is used to organize, analyze, and expand the OpenStack detection alarm. A cloud operator that has like a severe problem in the system, he might see a lot of alarms and it might be hard to understand what exactly went wrong. And this is exactly where Vitrage can help. So Vitrage collects information from different data sources. Some of them are OpenStack components like Nova, Cinder, Neutron, Heat, and some are external monitors like Nagios, Davix, or CollectV. And Vitrage combines all of this information in a topology graph. And the topology graph holds resources from the physical layer, the virtual layer, the application layer, the relations between them, and also the alarms that happen in the system, everything in one graph. And then Vitrage uses this information to provide insights about the state of the system. And in case of a problem, it can help the cloud operator by showing the exact root cause of all of the alarms that happened. And more than this, Vitrage actually raises additional alarms on resources that might not be directly monitored. For example, in case of a network problem, the host might become unreachable, and Nova may not even be aware of it. So Vitrage will notify Nova, and will raise alarms on the instances running on top of this host, and on the heat stacks that are using these instances. So the cloud operator will get a much more complete and holistic view of the status of the cloud.
What has happened during the pipe cycle? What new functionality or what changes have been made?
Okay, so in pipe we focused on the Vitrage usability and stability. We integrated Vitrage with Mistral. Mistral is the OpenStack workflow service. Vitrage in general is not a policy engine and it's not meant to execute recovery action, but the integration with Mistral lets the user decide that, for example, a certain alarm, in case of a certain alarm, he would like to run a recovery workflow in this one. And it's even more powerful than that because the user can decide that a different root cause they might want to execute different workflows in this one. So the combination of it in this one gives a lot of power to the user to do the exact recovery action.
And that's new in Pipe then?
Yeah, that's new in Pipe. Another thing that we invested the time in is that we completed the design of the Vitrage high availability and alarm history. We actually took two major issues and had a common design for them, and we started the implementation. As a first step, we separated the data collection into a different process. So it's now independent of the data processing and the evaluation. It's, of course, more stable and more efficient, and we plan to continue this effort in Queen. Another major issue is that we made the first steps towards machine learning in Vitrage. We introduced an infrastructure for adding machine learning algorithms, and we added the first basic algorithm, which is the Jaccard correlation, that tries to find correlation looking at the history of the alarm. In the future, we might want to add more complex algorithms and maybe even suggest templates to the user that he can use in the system. I think that after 2 years, Vitrage is a very stable project with all the main functionality in place. It's running in production. So we would like to focus on the stability and on enhancing the existing functionality. Like I said, we plan to continue the effort around alarm history. It means that the cloud operator can look on past alarms and see the root cause. I mean, the problems might be solved by now, but still looking at the root cause, he can determine what it should do next time. Another effort that we are going to do in Queens, I mean, it's an ongoing effort. We are always trying to add more data sources to Vitrage, because the more information Vitrage has, the more value it can provide to the user. So we would like to integrate with other OpenStack components, also maybe send notifications to other OpenStack components. This is another issue. Besides this, we have a very long backlog. I mean, we are working on configurable notifications, meaning you can try and register to notifications on specific alarm types or on specific resources. We are adding an SNMP parsing service, so Vitrage data sources can get SNMP drops as part of the information. We would like to enhance the template squad capabilities and maybe even add a template editor in the UI. There are more issues. I mean, these are just the things that seem more important. Let me say that Vitrage does not participate in the Denver PTG. Instead, we will hold a virtual PTG next month in October. So we have an info card, and I'd be happy to see other people add topics for discussions, for the planning, and of course, participate in the discussions. And we are looking for contributors, of course, so we'd be happy to help people get started.
If one wanted to read more about the project and see how one can contribute, where should we look?
Well, we have a wiki page with a lot of information and official documentation. Of course, you are welcome to email the mailing list.